Hey.
Every day with an intro.
Every day with an intro. Hey, my name is Nate. I've run a couple YC companies, I've run some other companies, and every day I upload a video talking about business and marketing and product development, just getting through life.
But I think because everything else is so green, it really...
Yeah. Today, let's talk about trees. I'm just kidding. We're not talking about trees. Let's talk about Rails is slow. So let's talk about a question I saw yesterday. Actually, I can't even find the question from yesterday because the developer deleted it. I wish they didn't. I thought it was an actually interesting question, although it was kind of a lazy question. They could have done some digging. They were actually just asking, how can I tell if I've had a performance improvement upgrading my app from Rails 3 to Rails 5? I had a few answers to this question. One of them being, like, you should already have performance monitoring in place so that you would have known you had an improvement. New Relic, App Signal, Skylight. All of these things have really cheap or free plans. You can even hack them so that you're not running them all the time, just run them when you need to. At High Rise, we only deployed New Relic to like a fraction of our servers. If we'd done it to all the servers, it would have been prohibitively expensive. So just put it on a couple. It's still a pretty good sample size to tell how your app is doing. The second thing is, you can just test this stuff yourself. Rails has had a performance testing framework since Rails 3. It's called like Rails perf test. It's a gem now, but it's easy to add back. But the thing that gets to me though is an underlying theme that I see in a lot of places, which is just like, Rails is slow. I see this over and over again still. I mean, Rails is now what, like 13 years old or something like that? I've been using it almost since the whole time. And it's been a complaint almost the whole time. I just saw it recently again. And here's the thing, a lot of people when they have a slow Rails app, they like to blame it on the framework. And so immediately they reach out to upgrading the framework. Like, hey, maybe Rails 3 sucked, let's get to Rails 5. There are improvements of the framework along the years. And there's improvements to Ruby over the years too that make things better, memory consumption, garbage collection, everything, yes. But I bet if you do this upgrade, it is not gonna solve the original problem that you are trying to solve probably. When you say your app is slow and you're looking to get performance improvements. Really, most people's problems are perceived slowness and actual slowness. Perceived slowness is things like, you just screwed up the design of the site and users say it feels slow, and it's often, there's too many steps in the way of them clicking on something and getting to what they need. The harder stuff is the real actual slowness. So you need to really talk to your users who are complaining about this thing to really understand, like, when you say slow, like, can you show me what you mean? You might just mean like some image loaded slow and I can fix that really fast. But if there's something actual going on, is there a specific action where, you know, you click this button to add a user, add an invoice or whatever, and that was slow? Now you've got a place to kind of dig into your log files and see what's happening for adding invoices or whatever that particular thing that you've pinpointed is slow. Now this is where I think is the problem with Rails. Rails makes us lazy. And I'm guilty of this too. Like, things are just so easy, you stop paying attention to our best practices and our craft as software developers, and we just start writing stuff and just getting it out there. And guess what happens? And this happens to a lot of new developers in Rails, but you don't really know then how to troubleshoot these things in your log files. So you gotta really dig into these log files, and it can look pretty crazy, but you're looking for things like slow database response times. You're looking for giant requests. Like, Rails requests should be kind of tiny. When they get to like this and there's database query after database query, something might be off. Like, you've just created hundreds of database queries when you only needed one. A good use of indices in your database are going to help those database queries often. Or using things like eager loading, which is like loading some stuff in one query so you don't have to issue dozens of queries for that same information. You could have just loaded it one time. Learn what stuff is really changing in your world and what's not, and learn where you can kind of like set up caches and blow those caches. These are things that, like, they're kind of difficult, but they should be part of your practice as a developer. I've done all of these things. I've gotten good at all of these things. And Draft, the writing software I use, and High Rise, these things are like really well hit applications with a lot of traffic, and we're able to do a lot of stuff without insane amounts of resources. I think Rails gets a bad rap at being slow. I think a lot of it is because we get lazy about using Rails because it's made our life so easy. Next time you're thinking about abandoning Rails because it's slow, it probably isn't slow. It's probably something someone has done that just really needs some very basic optimization and stuff that you should be learning anyways.
Brief walk to get lunch at Potbelly's.
What's the sandwich you're gonna get?
I don't know. I saw a sign about a new sandwich. I get excited about new Potbelly sandwiches.
You don't even know what it is?
No, I vaguely remember seeing it and being like, hey, that sounds like a good one. I have no idea what we're going to get. Oh, cheesesteak. That's what it was. We now also have a mint chocolate chip brownie cookie. She's not eating sugar. I really need to eat less sugar. I don't think we're getting the mint cookie. Maybe they're out of the cookies anyway. Yikes. It's like a whole meal and a cookie. I hope these aren't burned. Like, they had like a weird, someone, they weren't watching the machine and it like caught the meat. I didn't quite catch that on video, I don't think. But it's definitely like a, we had to warn them before something worse happened.